Welcome to the Easter watercolor tutorial. In three thematic videos, we will create a spring mood by painting beautiful flowers in decorated eggshells. Today we'll start with the daffodil flower, a symbol of the awakening of nature and spring renewal. Let's get started. We're starting with the eggshell using the wet and wet technique. First, I'm gently wetting the inside area with clean water. I recommend waiting a few minutes for the water to soak into the paper. Using brush number 6, I apply cerulean blue around the wet base. And then I gently blended with a clean, slightly damp brush to create a smooth transition. Now I'm adding blue dots with ultramarine. I'm applying a small amount of water to the area of the daffodil bulb. Then, adding bird sienna while the area is still wet. Now, gently blend the edges. You can add a slightly darker shade for the shadow areas. Then we create lighter areas by adding a drop of water. a touch of sap green. Next, we start painting the leaves using the wet and dry technique, leaving some areas unpainted to create a glossy effect on them. With slightly damp clean brush, I gently shade the edges and add a little shadow under the petal, while the stem is still wet. Additionally, I leave some highlights. After everything has dried, we begin painting the flower, starting with the outer petals. For the flower, we will need clean water and other yellow medium, or cadmium yellow deep. I take the medium brush and begin to gently wet the first petal with water. I'm applying the yellow color around the petal and adding a few stripes in the center. After the upper petals have dried, I start painting the lowers. For the core of the flower, I will use a mixture of azo yellow medium and permanent red light. As soon as all the petals are dry, I start adding the core, leaving the stamens unpainted. Adding a touch of green in the center between the stamens. I continue to paint the core, now adding permanent red light. After it's dried, I tint the stamens yellow. Using a mixture of yellow, leave a drop of red, add shadows to the petals, and gently blend the edges. A touch of red. Apply a drop of green in the center and blend the edges. At the end of our painting process, once the work has dried, we add a few final details. That's it for today. Next up, we'll be painting a tulip and a hyacinth. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next tutorials. See you!